السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله.
بسم الله والحمد لله رب العالمين، اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألف لام ميم، ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه، هدى للمتقين. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we are discussing verse number 1 of Surah Al-Baqarah. You know, Surah Al-Baqarah is the second surah, second chapter in Holy Quran. The first verse is Alif Lam Mim. It is three letters, three individual letters are there. Alif, Lam and Mim. The exact meaning of these two letters are known. It's known to Allah only, actually. But some mufassirs have given some meanings, some ideas. Okay, only that much. And here we are discussing based on Tafsir Ibn Kathir. The next verse is Zalikal Kitabu. And this is the book, or the revelation of this book. This is the book. This is the book. La rayba fih, and there is no doubt in it. Hudan, it's a guidance. Huda means guidance. Lil muttaqin, for the pious people. So in the first post, I have given the translation as wrong. That is, Alif Lam Mim, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. The translation is like this. That is, Alif Lam Mim, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ, that book means this book, that is the Holy Quran, لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ, there is no doubt in it. رَيْبَ means doubt, لَا means no. لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ, there is no doubt in it. فِيهِ means in it, that is in the Quran. Hudan, it is a guidance, huda, for whom? Lil muttaqeen, for the pious people, for the muttaqeen, for those people who have taqwa. Okay, so when I copied from on website the translation given, there was wrong. But I checked it later. Now I saw the correct meaning is like this. So in WhatsApp class, the first post translation will be wrong. But in other post, it will be correct, inshallah. It will be corrected, okay? Tafsir of verse 1. قد اختلف المفسرون في الحروف المقطعة التي في أوائل السور. قد اختلف. There are differences of opinion, or they differed. Who? المفسرون, the interpreters of Quran. في الحروف المقطعة, regarding the individual letters. التي في أوائل السور, which are there in the starting of some surahs. Alif Lam Mim, Ham Mim, Tawseen, Yaseen, like this. In 29 surahs, there are certain individual letters. Huruful Muqatta'a fi awa'il surah. Faminhum man qala, and there are some mufassirin who said, hiya mimma sta'zara Allahu bi'ilmih, its knowledge is with Allah only. And the meaning of those individual letters are known, or it is known to Allah only. And فَرَدُّوا عِلْمَهَا إِلَى اللَّهِ, so they returned the knowledge of those letters to Allah alone. وَلَمْ يَفَسِّرُهَا, and they didn't try to interpret those letters. They didn't give any tafsir, because they said, but its knowledge is with Allah only. They don't know the meaning, or men can't know its meaning. Okay. Now, حكاه القرطبي في تفسيره عن أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وابن مسعود. So all these mentioned Sahaba, they are of that opinion. That is, its knowledge is with Allah only. None can know it. So they didn't try to interpret those verses. Follow then. وقاله عامر الشعبي وسفيان الثوري وربيع بن حسين واختاره أبو حاتم ابن حبان. So all these people preferred that view. Okay. Now, next. ومنهم من فسرها واختلف هؤلاء في معناها. ومنهم, and there are people among the mufassirin, those who interpreted these individual letters, just like Alif Lam Mim, Yasin, Tawasin, Tawasin Mim, like that. Tawasin Mim, like that. من فسرها واختلف, and they differed, هؤلاء, these people, that means those people, those mufassirin, those interpreters who interpreted, who gave tafsir to these individual letters, differed in fi ma'naha, in its meaning. So some people interpreted it, but they differed in their tafsirs. Different tafsirs are available for these individual letters. قال عبد الرحمن بن زيد بن أسلم إنما هي أسماء الصور. عبد الرحمن بن زيد بن أسلم said, those letters in the beginning of some surahs, some chapters, they are nothing but the meaning, the names of those surahs, the names of those surahs, chapters. قال العلامة أبو القاسم محمود. No. وقال سفيان الثوري عن ابن أبي نجيح عن مجاهد أنه قال ألف لام ميم وحاميم وألف لام ميم صاد وصاد فواضح افتتح الله بها القرآن. Those individual letters are nothing but فواضح, openings. افتتح الله, Allah opened بها, with those letters, القرآن. The Quran, the Quran was opened by those letters by Allah. وكذا قال غيره عن مجاهد. قال مجاهد في رواية أبي حذيفة موسى بن سعيد عن شبل عن ابن أبي نجيح عنه أنه قال ألف لام ميم اسم من أسماء القرآن. And another view is that ألف لام ميم is the name of, one of the names of Quran, one of the names of Quran. No. قيل, and it is that هي أسماء من أسماء الله تعالى. It is, that is, Alif Lam is one of the names of Allah. One of the names of Allah. فقال شعبي فواتح السور من أسماء الله تعالى. And شعبي said, those are among the names of Allah, and they are used, those individual letters, or those letters are the names of Allah, and they are used as opening of these, of the surah chapters. Now, عن السدي بلغني أن ابن عباس قال سدي, إمام سدي said, بلغني, it is reached to me, that is I got the knowledge. What? أن ابن عباس قال, suddenly ابن عباس رضي الله عنه said, ألف لام ميم اسم من أسماء الله الأعظم, هكذا رواه ابن أبي هاتم من حديث شعبة ورواه ابن جرير عن بندار. ابن عباس رضي الله عنه said, Alif Lam Mim, one of the names of Allah, Ismul Allah. Okay, no. Another report. سألت السدية سدية أن حامي متواصل وألف لام فقال ابن عباس هي اسم الله الأعظم. ابن عباس said ألف لام ميم تواصل حام ميم. All these are Allah's names. Allah's names. Okay. Then. وروي أيضا من حديث شريك بن عبد الله عن طاء بن السائب عن أبي الضحى عن ابن عباس قال ألف لام ميم أنا الله أعلم. And another report is that it is Ibn Abi Hatim and Ibn Jarir records that Ibn Abbas said Alif Lam Mim means Alif Allah. Alif Ana. Alif means Ana. Lam Allah. Mim means A'lam. So Alif Lam Mim means Ana Allah A'lam. I am Allah the knowing the best. Knowing the best. Who knows the best? I am Allah who knows the best. أنا الله أعلم. That is another تفسير.